Honourable members, I still can remember the way the queue was. I'm still applying my memory to it.
Mr. Speaker, thank you very much. I want to say upfront that I support this amendment because it will allow us to get proceeds from anything that we float abroad to come back to our country. But Mr. Speaker, I want to say this is in anticipation of what we did in our budget. And I hope members remember that we did pass a budget that encompasses some proceeds from a sovereign bond that we are supposed to float abroad. But not only is this a sovereign bond, it's actually a euro bond, meaning it's priced in other currencies other than the Kenyan shillings. And Mr. Speaker, we are very lucky as a country because this is the best time in terms of macroeconomic environment in Eurozone to float a sovereign bond. For those of you who understand bond pricing, there is an inverse relationship between bond prices and the interest rates. If you look at Europe today and the US, they're partially in a liquidity trap, meaning interest rates and inflation are almost near zero. So there is no better time to float a bond than when you have a situation where a zone is or an area is in a liquidity trap. But we have to be careful, and we need to move with a lot of speed, because already if you watch the anything economics around the world, it is European Central Bank is already talking of quantitative easing, meaning they want to start doing something to raise up interest rates. So as a country, we need to move very fast. And Mr. Speaker, why do we want to float a bond in the first place? Why do we want to do this? First of all, we put our budget, the proceeds from this bond. But more importantly, Mr. Speaker, if we were to float a bond today outside of this country, there are obvious things that anybody can tell you. Our country today is crowded. The market is crowded because the government is borrower. The government is competing with foreign investors and local investors to borrow from local banks. So immediately we get some money from the government moves out of the borrowing market. That allows for demand of loans to go down and the interest rates to go down. But Mr. Speaker, we also know this is a fact that our government today owes about 52 billion of syndicated loans across different banks, and that is putting a lot of pressure on the borrowing across our country. If we were to get these proceeds and pay these loans, the government will save a lot of money, and that's what we've been talking about for so long. We have a high debt ratio, and this debt is very expensive. I saw a member today standing here that, if you were to float a bond in Europe today, you will not gain anything as a government in terms of reduced interest rate. I want to say this. If you look at the junk bonds today in the US, junk bonds, forget about sovereign bonds. They are trading at about 6%. So, if assuming our country was junk, we could still get a 6% interest rate. I think that is a big benefit. Mr. Speaker, the other benefit is the reputation that we get. I think we are getting into these markets very late. The first bonds were traded in 1600. The first one was by Britain to finance the war against France. We need to move as a country. It is unfortunate that at this late age, we are not present in the bond market outside of this country, and we need to move very fast and be represented there. But Mr. Speaker, I also want to speak on the Anglo leasing, because Mr. Speaker, this bond and Anglo leasing are not mutually exclusive. If you know how bonds are priced, you cannot expect to sell a bond and get a good price as a country and get many proceeds that will support our budget without clearing the small debt that we have. Default risk is one of the things that is priced between the bond calculus. So we have to pay this thing so that our bond can fetch a higher premium, and then we can have a lot of money to do things like CDF and everything else we are talking. So, Mr. Speaker, I want to go on record that we, as a country, there are just so much benefits that we get. In fact, if you look at the savings on interest rates alone, if interest rates were reduced by a mere 2%, our country will save about 20 billion Kenya shillings. And what is Anglo leasing? 1.4. I cannot and I will never put Kenyans into a corner, just saying that because it's morally wrong to pay Anglo leasing, I will not pay 1.4 so that Kenyans can benefit with $20 billion. I think it's foolhardy, and that is something that I will never support. Mr. Speaker, the other thing is, there is a famous saying in English that you cannot have your cake and eat it at the same time. If you guys want this money to finance our budget, If you truly pass the budget in this house that encompasses proceeds from that bond, you cannot say we cannot pay Anglo leasing, and that will affect our bond pricing, but we also want to, you know, that thing of eating a cake and having it at the same time. Mr. Speaker, I think I make my point. I want to go on record. Please pay Anglo leasing. It's the best thing for our country. We'll save on interest rates. We'll get a lot of money to do our budget. I support the government, the president, and this is a bipartisan issue. Abdikadi is in the opposition, and these other guys, not in the opposition, I'm sorry. There is nobody in this house in the opposition. These are colleagues. We know what we are doing. They understand these calculus. Mbadi is one of them. Abdikadi is one of them. Those people understand economics. This is the best thing that will happen in our country. Thank you.